Welcome to Moovieboy, the place to go for prime digital cuts in photography, graphic design, and special effects. I am Tom Sorensen, aka Moovieboy, and on today's menu is Adobe Photoshop layer masks with our celebrity guest Scarlett Johansson. Ow! So the way we're going to do tutorials here at Moovieboy is we're going to have a beginner section and a more advanced section. So if you're already comfortable with what a layer mask is and you just want to get down into the dirt, then just look down into the description and click the timestamp to skip ahead. But either way, stick around towards the end of the video when I'll talk about a tip that I've used for about 10 years now of how to effectively clean up a mask. Because regardless of how you get to cutting something out, you're going to get to that place where there's pieces you know you're missing. And either way, stick around even longer to see an additional tip on how to deal with parts of the hair if it's still not looking right even after you've cut it out. Otherwise, here we go. So the first thing is, what is a layer mask? Well, simply put, anytime you want to start combining images or you want to remove something from it, like replace the sky or add something in the front, like an alien or a 3D model, you're going to have to start hiding or erasing parts of it. Now, a lot of people start thinking about getting rid of elements, and the first thing they want to do is use the eraser. And it's an easy mistake, it's right there in the toolbox. If you're thinking of using the eraser at any time in Photoshop, I've got a word of warning for you. You're bad. You're a bad, 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 bad designer. Yes, you are. And the reason why is that eraser is not a helper. Yes, it is bad. The eraser is bad, just like she is. I would remove the eraser from the Photoshop toolbar if I could, because 99.9% of the time when you want to use it, you shouldn't. And here's the reason why. In Photoshop, you want to work non-destructively. So you don't want to erase something. When you erase it, it's gone. If you ever need it back for whatever reason, it's been destroyed. What you want to do is hide things, not erase things. And this is where layer masks come into play.
Okay, so here we are, starting with this lovely photo from the red carpet of Scarlett Johansson. First thing we're going to do, actually, is make a new layer. And I have a tendency to name my layers as I go along. I think it's a good habit to get into. Then you can go over here into the toolbar and choose the quick selection tool, otherwise accessed by hitting the hotkey W. You may be seeing the magic wand tool in place, but you can just click and hold and bring up the quick selection tool if it's not already available. The brush size you can increase and lower as you need, or you can just simply hit the left and right bracket keys to go bigger or to go smaller, whatever you need. I really, really love this tool because it gives you a very quick way to select what you need. Hold down the Alt or Option key to unselect that portion. Don't be too concerned with trying to grab every little detail at this point, unless you see something that's really out of whack. Let's turn off the layer behind her. Because once we activate the layer mask, if we have the same layer behind her, you won't see any changes. How do you activate the layer mask? Easiest way is to simply go down here to the bottom of the layers window, and you'll see this icon down here. And it says add layer mask. Now I can click it, and everything that was selected by the quick selection tool is maintained visible while it hides everything here.
All right, so a lot of tutorials will actually start oversimplifying when they talk about layer masks. They'll say that once they're activated, and you're looking at that white screen, they'll say that anything that's white is what you can see, and anything that's black will be hidden away or transparent. That's making things a little too simple, because it's not just white pixels and black pixels. It's actually the whole gradation, like this one right here, going from 0 to 255. So you have 256 levels of transparency. So you can have halfway transparent or fully transparent. And I know some of you are looking over here and they're going, okay, it's 255, why are you saying 256? Because 0 is actually a level as well. And as everyone knows, 255 plus 0 is 256. Yeah, that sounded better when I wrote it.
You can actually deactivate this. By doing so, once you've got it selected, is you can just hold down the Shift key and tap on it. That'll put a big red X over it, and that will actually let you toggle on and off the mask to see how well of a job you did. There's a word of warning here, and this is easy to do both as a beginner, and you will find yourself still doing it even after 10, 20 years, is that you have to make sure, what do you have selected in this layer? Because now you've got the image, and watch, if I select the image, you'll now see that this portion around it is highlighted with a white frame, so that if I start taking a brush, for example, and start painting black, I'm painting on the pixels and ruining the image. Let's undo that. Whereas if you select the mask, you'll see now this is highlighted. And in doing so, painting black will now actually erase things out, make them hidden, which in this case we also don't want.
So that wraps up the beginner portion. So for those of you who have jumped ahead, welcome to the advanced section, where we really start using the layer mask and find out how to effectively remove something from the background or vice versa.
Now that you have this selected, you can go up to the select menu and you can go down to refine mask, or if you want, simply double click on that mask. And if it isn't available, it's the properties pop-up window that will come up. That can also be accessed by going to window and going down to properties. If you have this part clicked, if you have this part clicked, you'll see it says no mask selected. So make sure you have that selected. We don't need to feather the mask. We don't need to worry about the density of the mask behind it. We need to fix this edge around the hair and around the dress. So we're going to select mask edge. And what you'll see now is suddenly the image is against white. And that's the view mode up here in the refine mask window. You actually have a number of choices, which is really helpful depending on what image you're working on. You can have marching ants, although personally this doesn't help in this particular case for me. It rarely does. You can have an overlay of a kind of a quick mask look. You can put the image against black, which is helpful if your image edges would start bleeding into the white too much. On white, black and white, on the layer, reveal the layer. Whatever helps to refine this mask and see what you're working on is helpful. But in this case, on white for me will work just fine. And you can click on that again to close the window. I prefer to use the smart radius in the edge detection. Move this out of the way and start painting along the outline so that you're catching both the foreground and the background element you want to remove. And depending on how complex the image is, the computer will try and work things out. And for example, it should see that the blonde hairs here against the dark are good. It should also pick out these darker hairs against the light blue. And sure enough, it does a much better job, definitely better than what the quick selection tool was doing. Now, it is not perfect, and we have ways of dealing with that. And you'll see it really does struggle as it picks up colors in the background that are very similar to those in the foreground, and the computer doesn't know what's meant to be removed. And so you'll start getting these strange image artifacts around it, or noise, depending on how much noise is in your original image. It's never gonna be perfect unless you have an absolutely perfect background that's easy to remove. So just hit okay, and we go back and we save again, because that's what we do.
Okay, you've made it this far. So here is an additional tip to help you clean up your mask to see what parts you're still missing.
Okay, so here we are with a mask that is most of the way there. And it doesn't matter how you got to this point. When you work on, let's select this mask, and let's go to the mask edge again. Now, it's interesting that when you work on the refine edge, it's giving you this white background so you can see your pixels better. The moment you hit OK, you're back to the checkerboard. Now, the checkerboard, of course, is meant to tell you that what's transparent and what's not. But as you start trying to get into some of these finer details, you're really starting to get kind of lost as far as clearly seeing, especially if you guys are watching this on YouTube, what pixels are there? Are there areas here that are semi-transparent that are just hanging around? How do we see this? Well, here is a technique I've used for years. First thing you do is select underneath and make a new layer. You can just simply click on the new layer, create new layer button down here at the bottom of the layer window. So we're going to click on that. And we're going to click on it again. There we go. Now I want you to fill that with white. Well, this helps a lot. Now we can better see pixels and hair strands, areas where we've got some fuzziness. Well, the problem is, even this, I mean, as we start getting in towards these white layers, it's kind of hard to tell where things are. So we have another part of the tip, and that is to select your object and make a layer above her now. Now I want you to fill that with black. Okay, look at that. It's beautiful. And now you're done. What you need to do, and this may be a little advanced for some people, so we're going to do this carefully. Bring your cursor. Go to the line in between that black layer and your object. Keep it in between the two. And now hold down that Alt or Option key. And you'll see, as you kind of hover over the between those two layers, it turns into a little arrow and a little white box. What it's telling you is that you're about to create a clipping mask. And yes, in the future, I will do a clipping mask tutorial. We are going to say anything that's visible on this layer, in this case, Scarlett Johansson, anything that's visible, clip that mask and apply it to the layer above it as well. So what will happen is I'm going to click between these two layers, and now you'll see a little arrow appear here to tell you that you in fact have turned this into a clipping layer. And if you hold down that key again and press again, you'd be removing it as a clipping path. But we want it because look what we have now. Boom. Now we can see very clearly where things fell apart, where things have got noise, where the areas have totally missed in keeping the mask. And see, it's a much clearer image than what we have here. Now, this takes a little bit of finessing, a little bit of practice to make sure that you're staying on the right layer, because we don't want to paint on the black layer. That's not going to help us. We want to work on this layer, but we don't want to work on the image. We want to work on the mask. So make sure that's highlighted. Otherwise, we're about to paint black and white stripes on Scarlett's face. So now, this is where it gets down to the detail, gets down to the nitty gritty. You're going to have to take your brush tool, and we want to preserve this area. So we make sure we have the white as our foreground. Now we are painting on that layer mask and getting these details back. Now eventually, of course, you start getting to areas where you go, okay, wait, I can't even see what it is. You can turn off that layer. With it still selected, hold on the shift, click on it, and turn to X. Just start painting with your white brush on the mask, not on this, otherwise you're going to start doing this, while it is currently temporarily turned off. It still will work. So if you're painting white on that mask, just follow around. This is probably tough to see, but maybe you can make out the little circle still. I'm doing a very faint outline. And you know, I'm even going to run up the side of this a little bit to help show the point. So I'm very lightly, well not lightly, I'm carefully going around the edge. How's that going to help? Well, let's get that layer activated again, and I'm going to turn back on the black layer above it. Ta-da! Now you can see exactly where you need to stop. You've painted the edge. Now you can actually go in with a lasso tool, or you can just paint it in as well, but sometimes this is faster. Fill. And we will fill it with white, which of course made it black, which I'm sure has got to be confusing. You'll need to practice a few times for yourself. The reason why I'm doing it this way is because usually I'd be cutting out characters that would have to be against a white background. So the silhouette was kind of helping. But if it helps to make things better, you can invert each of these by going down to adjust and going down to invert, or just hit Command I or Control I if it helps better. And this is actually in compositing in, say, After Effects. This is typically what you'd be doing for a clean mask anyway, is that the white would be prominent and the black would be the background omitted areas to be made invisible. If this helps you instead, let's do that instead. Either way works fine for me. Now, as we zoom in, you can clearly see that this arm has some issues, a lot of issues. We've got this area here where the background obviously tried to keep. So we go back to the mask, make sure that's selected, and we want to paint that part out. And again, we may speed this up I'm going to hit X to go back to a white brush and paint back in the parts of the arm that we know are supposed to be there. I'm obviously rushing a little bit through as well, since this is a tutorial.
Okay, and here is one additional tip for how to deal with hair. What are you doing?
So what you can do, if you want to, is make a new layer. Call it hair. What you can do is that you can make this into a one pixel brush. You can make the opacity, the flow of this brush, be less than 100%. It can be like 40, a lot of times I'll do like 20. You can go down to the eyedropper tool, or you can hit I and select, and you can go back to hit B or choose the brush, and you can choose to lightly paint some of those hairs back in. Now, of course, it takes practice, and you can just choose to paint some of those back in. There's nothing wrong with that. And you just get a general feel for the way the hairs go, and we are going to bring in our background layer just to composite her. So we're going to bring in the Egyptian theater from Hollywood. Pull that off and drag that into her layer. And we've turned her into the Egyptian theater. This is another example of how the clipping mask works so well. But if you put it in between a clipped layer and its original layer underneath, it too will become a clip mask. So I need to get that out of there. There we go. I see a couple of problem spots. So we've got this area here where the hair, because of its translucency, because of the amount of actual data in the pixels from the original photograph, things really are not compositing too well here. Now we want to keep the detail, so it, unless you want to trim it off, just for the sake of trimming it off, you know, you can erase that section as well. I should say layer mask that section as well. Problem is, what if you really want to keep that hair? Well, there is a solution. So what you can do is make a new layer and also keep it as a clipping layer. And we will name this hair fringe. And what you can do is you can, on this empty layer, select a nearby pixel, in this case the hair that we want to replicate. Let's bring this down to say 20% again, and let's start painting. In so doing, we are starting to affect these hairs. So they're not so gray anymore, transparent, you know, semi-transparent gray. Now they're more of a transparent hair color. And as you can see, if you're careful about how you're painting that in, at the very least, you get something that is compositing a little bit better. Now, of course, we need to adjust the color a little bit here. Try and keep things ridiculous. And because we've kept this as a clipping mask, it is forming and matching the mask underneath. If we were to hold down the Option or Alt key and click between those layers to release it, as you can see, we would just have a bunch of paint splotches. If we take this black layer and bring that underneath, now you can really see the difference of what we're doing by painting these hairs back in. So now we have Scarlett Johansson at a premiere at the Egyptian Theater. Woohoo!
Well, that wraps things up for this episode of Movie Boy. If you have any additional questions, feel free to comment below, and I will try and answer them as quickly as possible. Also, if there's a different part of Photoshop you'd like to see in a future tutorial, please let us know in the comments. Or if there's a celebrity that you love that you would like to see in a future tutorial that I might have in my celebrity photo library, let us know in the comments. Otherwise, thanks for sticking around, and for sticking around to the end, I have yet an additional tip. You can click here to see what happens if you need to apply a layer mask to your layer mask. So, thank you again. Like and comment below. Always remember to subscribe to get more tutorials. And thank you, and come again.